One, two. What's up, New York? What's up, world? What's up? What's up? I am the scratch creator, Grand Wizard Theodore, Boogie Down Bronx, New York City. So happy to be here. So happy to have you here with me. Going to do this special edition, Mobile Mondays, all 45 special mix by Grand Wizard Theodore. And remember, every time I touch the turntables, I make history. Why? Because I've been doing this since I was 12 years old. Let's go.
You don't want the truth because deep down in places you don't talk about at parties. You want me
on the wheels of steel.
You need me on that.
Turntables, tables, tables.
So I'm getting ready to get scratching.
One, two, three, four.
Here we go.
Ah! Yeah!
So fresh, so clean.
You can hear me scratching it, which you guys might be able to hear that or not. You can barely hear it. But that scratch is a little bit deeper than most of the other scratches.
It's empty.
Definitely hear me scratching that guy.
Aw, shit.
Listen closely.
Just listen. Stop. And listen to the DJ.
She's such a sexy lady, filled with space age design. She's moving, she's grooving, dancing to the music spot now.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Better call somebody. Tell them about Grand Wizard Theodore. Tell them about Mobile Mondays. How much history. And how many DJs get to expose their 45s that they hot in their closets, hot under their bed? 45s that they stole from their parents' house. Special mix, baby. Here we go.
What?
That's right. I am hip hop. Let's go. Want to take this time out to apologize to my mother for stealing her 45s, playing them in the park. And I know a lot of you DJs out there should be apologizing to your parents as well. Let's go. Special thanks to my man Chris. Shout out to Rebecca and the Mobile Monday staff. Here we go. Hope you're enjoying this. Beautiful day in New York City. Thank you.
without you. I just can't make it, darling. I can't keep on being lonely. And if I did you wrong, I'm so sorry now, dear.
Oh yeah. Shout out to all my New Yorkers out there. Uh-huh. This is how we do it. Grand Wizzard Theodore. We'll be right back.
Uh-huh. If you don't know about Mobile Mondays, better ask somebody. Shout out to all my DJs out there that's digging for those 45s, digging for those vinyls. You know who you are.
Thank you.
Yeah, feeling funky today, huh? Shout out to Kenny Dope. Uh-huh. Oh yeah.
I gotta see my way around.
Shout out to my partner, the original DJ Jazzy J. We're going to be doing it up at Mobile Mondays,
get on my ladder, woman.
The 29th.
There is another going to make me stop.
Better tell somebody.
Get up the way, you woman. I've got to be moving on. Get up the way, you woman. I've got to be moving on.
Shout out to DJ Kool Herc, Africa Bambaataa, Grandmaster Flash, the original L Brothers, Fantastic Five, Cold Crush Brothers. Big shout out to the cast of the new Netflix series, The Get Down. Shout out to Boz Lerman. Uh-huh. Here we go. Shout out to the Scratch Academy. shout out to Dusty Fingers. Beat man Danny Dan. Just a preview you of what's gonna happen at the Mobile Mondays with Grand Wizzard Theodore, partner, the original Jazzy J. We're gonna definitely go in. This is only part one. You want to see part two? Come check out Mobile Mondays.
Like wow, yeah, can't dial it back. Style, think you keep bringing that style back. P-I-I-2-L's like a rock bell. Don't forget bell, analyze every word I sell. Over most every rapper who can't write these kind of rhymes that are designed to make ordinary MCs drop the knees from the higher degrees of the fire we make. But not Alicia Keys and Maxwell, three brothers who rap well on a Maxell. Set the X fell on the next of whoever next to flex. Next to text or tweet links to the little rhymes over beats on YouTube or SoundCloud. Make the music sound loud so you find the ground that's destructive.
Yeah. Middle for you all by now. One, two.
Thank you. Cool. Wow. So we're in the green room, the DJ green room with Chris Landry, and Theodore just did a killer set.
Yep. Thank you.
So if that's anything to go by, Mobile Mondays on Monday is going to be pretty, pretty hot. And we're, of course, adding Jazzy J to that. I wanted to ask you first how you and Jazzy J met back in the day. How did that come about?
When I was down with the L Brothers, which is right. My brother Mean Gene and Cordio, Jazzy J was down with Afrika Bambaataa,
right,
and Zulu Nation, and they were on the other side of town in Bronx River. I mean, we were all rivals and stuff like that, but it never got to the point where we wanted to blow each other's houses up and stuff like that. You know, it was
competition.
Yeah, it was friendly competition, yeah. And stuff like that. When I first saw Jazzy, perform, and I was like, wow, you know, I got some serious competition out here, you know? And, you know, throughout the years, you know, we became friends, and, you know, ever since then, we've been friends ever since, you know?
Cool. So Monday, you are playing with us at Mobile Mondays, which is at Barry Electric, all 45s.
Yes, I'm so much looking forward to this.
Yeah, so
I'll have to check this off of my bucket list.
Yeah, I'm surprised you haven't been down yet, but I'm really glad you're coming. And so I have a question from my godson, Namali, just ask this question.
Okay.
Compared to back in the day, there's, you know, modern hip hop, there's a lot less scratching involved in the production. What do you think of that? Do you, when you think about it, pretty much, well, especially, you know, there was always a DJ scratching in most tracks.
Well, I think if it's gotten to the point where a lot of people are suing for tracks, a lot of people are
right.
wanting to get copyrights and stuff like that. I mean, if you scratch a James Brown sample or any, you know, funk group sample, I mean, they eventually, you know, want to get paid, you know, because
right.
a lot of these groups, you know, from the 70s and the 60s, a lot of these groups didn't get paid what they should have gotten paid. And when someone samples their music, some of that music is going double platinum and triple platinum. So I feel that these artists should definitely get some kind of compensation. So I think it's gotten to the point where people just say, well, let's just not even scratch any samples in the song, and then we won't really have to pay anybody. That's just my point of view.
Right, right. But do you think that can kind of hurt the industry in a little bit, because then people pull back on something that could be creative because they're afraid of someone coming after them and suing them? I'm just thinking things like Jamaica, because in Jamaica they take anything and throw out 10 million records and you know, just wait for someone to find them. But I feel like sometimes now we got very controlled by the industry, like, oh, no, well, I can't do that because then someone will come and I haven't got permission. So the creativity gets a little bit stilted. Do you think that's...
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's like, you know, from back in the 90s, where everybody was sampling.
Right.
Everybody was using scratches from different groups and stuff like that. I think it's gotten to the point where, like, basically 90% of all the scratches have been used, you know, and people want to try to get more creative and try to limit it to scratching and stuff like that. But I mean, you know, scratching is a part of hip hop. It's a part of the culture. I mean, it's like you can't have hip hop without the B-boy. You can't have hip hop without the MC. You can't have hip hop without the graffiti artist. You can't have hip hop without the knowledge. And you can't have hip-hop without the DJ. So as far as scratching is concerned, I mean, you got to have some kind of scratching in it, you know?
So, yeah. You want to ask about the Get Down? I know you... Yeah, we'd like to know your opinion on the Get Down. We have been... I think everyone would like to know everyone's opinion on the Get Down.
I mean, my opinion on the Get Down, I mean, I think the Get Down is definitely a platform to shed light on, you know, the early days of hip hop. I mean, it's gotten to the point where when people talk about hip hop, they talk about the 80s all the way up to 2016.
Right.
What happened to 1979? What happened to 1978?
Yes. Very true.
77, 76. What happened to all the years that's gone by before anybody even thought about putting hip hop on wax? And I think that Netflix, you know, and Baz Luhrmann have definitely depicted, you know, what everybody's, the questions that everybody should be asking. What spawned hip hop? I mean, what our life was like before we, you know, started doing hip hop. And I think that this, the Get Down movie sheds a lot of light on what we went through in the early days, the blood, sweat, and tears we went through, the, what we went through as far as, like, you know, single-parent homes and all the abandoned buildings, and the government don't want to put no more money back into the boroughs. Everything is getting burnt down. You know, the schools and drugs and stuff like that. All of that played a part in the development in the beginnings of hip-hop, because we wanted to try to escape our everyday lives, everything that was going on that was negative in our life that we was, like, basically seeing every day. So, you know, the B-boys would B-boy to get out some energy. The graffiti artists would end up painting murals to depict what was going on inside their mind, you know, the different colors and stuff like that. Then you got the DJs that were, you know, playing music. And then you got the MCs that was writing down their thoughts on paper and spitting it out on the microphone. So, you know, all of that played a part. And I think the Get Down pretty much depicts what the question everybody's asking, and I think it gives everybody a real serious glimpse into what early hip hop was like, and I'm very satisfied with the with the first six episodes, and then we got the rest of the seven episodes is coming up, and I think that people should definitely look at this and realize that this story had to be told.
Yes, I enjoyed it. So I have one quick question, because you're coming down to Mobile Mondays on next Monday on the 29th. That's at Bowery Electric. Just a 45 question, because you and Jazzy are going to be doing all 45s.
Yes.
If you could put out a 45 that has not yet been put out, what would you pick?
A 45.
Something that never came out on 45, so a track that you would like to put out on a 45 that has not been.
Wow. I mean, it's gotten to the point where it's like everything is out on the 45, you know?
Yes, true.
But I truly believe that if I was to put out a track on a 45, it would be James Brown, Give It Up, Turn It Loose. I don't know if it's out on the 45. I don't know if it was played in jukeboxes or not, because I've never seen James Brown, Give It Up, Turn It Loose on a 45, and that would probably be what I would put out on a 45.
Okay, cool. Well, I'll wait to see that.
Yes, yes.
All right, well, thank you very much, and we will see everyone on Monday the 29th at Bowery Electric, 10 p.m.
Be there. Tell somebody. Peace.